From Medisa, we headed to Negombo. The drive is roughly of 4 hours and a comfortable one as well, as it's on the highway. We stayed at Negombo, which is roughly 20 minutes from the airport. The hotel that we chose for our stay was Dickman Resort. This is a private paradise with a no children policy. Features 9 exclusive and well decorated rooms, along with a charming mango garden and large eco-friendly swimming pool. The rooms are quite spacious and has collectibles as well. The washroom is huge and has an open door towards the end. Don't worry, it was completely safe experience as the space is enclosed and belongs to you only. We stayed there for 2 nights and it was quite an experience for us. The breakfast spread is really great. You can choose from a wide variety of fruits and continental flavors. There is a small water body where you can see fishes and even turtles out there. That's a map of Colombo, along with what are the places that you can visit. It's a very nice and calm place, and the staff is really helpful, especially the person on the front desk. He helped us get the tuk-tuk during our return trip to the airport as well. The pool is 8 feet deep, so kind of good for swimming. There are usually flies around the food area in Sri Lanka, maybe due to the tropical climate. We noticed a battery-operated fan, which solves the problem quite uniquely. They also have an in-house restaurant and tie-ups with some local ones, and you can order food from there. We tried the pasta, and it was really nice. Next day, we hired a tuk-tuk, and we booked on Uber, and we set out for our Colombo day trip. The streets in Colombo are much different from that of any other place in Sri Lanka, but very similar to the large cities in comparable countries like India, for example. There are ample number of water bodies in Sri Lanka, some dirty, some clean, but there is no dearth of water around. That is what we observed. And fishing boats are galore because that seems to be one of the main source of livelihood, both from consumption and export purpose. You can see offices of prominent banks, retail outlets, and even street shops selling some souvenirs or local items. We went there on 25th and it was kind of deserted. Our first stop was the Ministry of Crab, located in the Dutch Fort area. If you come to Sri Lanka and don't eat a mud crab, then what's the point? This is a restaurant where Sri Lankan cricketers Mahila Jayawardena and Kumara Sangakkara are co-founders. The crab was delicious and soft. It took us 2 hours to complete the meal. Just a note, this restaurant is one of the most expensive ones in Sri Lanka as well. Once we were done, we headed out to explore Sri Lanka on foot. We went to Jami-ul-Alfar Masjid, popularly known as Red Mosque. Its tall minarets are seen from almost every street, towering over the hustle and bustle of the busy neighborhood street. It is said to be a landmark for sailors approaching the port of Colombo. We don't know how true that is. It is a distinct red and white pattern. There are 2 sections, one for locals and one for tourists. Since we took too much time to eat crabs, we decided to skip the entry and appreciate the architectural beauty from outside. We then headed to Gangaramaya Temple, which is one of the most important temples in Sri Lanka. The temple's architecture demonstrates a mix of Sri Lankan, Thai, Indian and Chinese architecture. It has a main worship hall where the different life stages of Buddha is explained through pictures. There are other sub halls as well, where some are museums. And then There are educational halls. There are places where the monks stay. You would stand there and appreciate the grandeur of the place, both of the statue as well as the architecture. Just a note, you have to dress conservatively and you have to keep your shoes outside. You have to cover your shoulders so that you respect the tradition of this place and the culture. Here it's demonstrated that what are the important things that are there to be seen inside the temple complex. You can see a Buddha guarded by two elephant tusks. There is some construction activity that is also going on, maybe towards conservation of this place. I would suggest that you go there, you would find peace, and it's kind of very serene out there as well. Not many tourists, but still, you would appreciate the rich history of Buddhism, and whatever items that are on display, you would get to know more about them because there are descriptions written out there, very clearly explained for tourists. There are lots of parrots as well in this temple complex. In one such section, you would find that there are multiple Buddha statues as well. This one is gold plated. You saw many local people as well. There is a huge lifelike elephant statue. At first, you would kind of be in awe and you think that it might be a real elephant, but then you realize that it is a statue only. Very lifelike kind of. It would take you roughly 30 minutes to observe the entire place, see the different things that are there. This is a jade statue of Buddha. One might be original and another might be a replica of the same. These are various collectibles that are on display. Beneath those, it's written that from which place it has been collected. I'm sure you would get to know a bit more about Buddhism if you visit this place. And if you're interested in culture, then this place might not disappoint you. As I was mentioning, that there are many parrots that you can observe in this temple complex. On the streets, we found this architecture that is made of mechanical items. It was right there on the street as you leave the temple complex. We again took an Uber. Uber is easily available in Sri Lanka. There is another app called Pick My Ride, but I think that there you have to have a local number for that. But since we didn't take an international SIM, we had international roaming on the other hand, so we preferred Uber. We then headed for our COVID test at Nevaloka Hospital. Please note that you have to go there physically to collect the test result, as they don't send any soft copy on email or WhatsApp. We ended our day with a Christmas dinner. Fellow travelers from Norway, Australia, Finland joined us. It was a unique experience where we shared our travel stories, life experiences over wine and delicious Italian food. I must thank Tikman Resort for organizing this. The price was 5,000 LKR per head for the dinner and a bottle of wine for each member. Our return trip to India was smooth as well. We landed in Kolkata, where we were greeted with the illuminated skyline. It was a memorable 1 week in Sri Lanka. Hope you enjoyed the other videos as well of this series. We are kind of looking forward to our next trip, wherever that would be.